Today, I will share with you 12 great habits you should start today to achieve optimal health and longevity. Welcome back to Big City Mom Channel. On my channel, I discuss not only diet, but various different strategies you can implement into your life to achieve health and longevity. And today, it's time to put it all into one comprehensive list. I have 12 of these habits, so I will break them up into two videos so it doesn't get too long. So here's my first six. Let's start with number one, and that is cut out from your diet sugar and seed oils. And I lump them together because they oftentimes come together in the form of processed foods. So processed foods typically will be all kind of baked goods, fries, chips, and they consist of starches, grains with seed oils, which is a proper name for vegetable oils, the heart healthy vegetable oils. You have no business of having them in your diet. And when it comes to processed foods, there's a lot more to the story than these two offenders, and that's all kind of cheap preservatives, artificial colorings, food stabilizers, preservatives of freshness. You don't want it in your diet. Not a little bit, not ever. Get rid of it. You're not going to miss out on anything, and your health will get a lot better. When it comes to sugar consumption, all you need for a day is 25 grams of sugar, which equates more or less to 5 teaspoons of sugar from everything that you eat, which includes things like pasta or bread or potatoes, which don't have sugar listed on them, but they're full of starch, and in the end, this too gets converted into glucose. So as you see, our bodies don't need that much sugar to function optimally, and we eat a lot more than this on standard American diet. 35, 40, sometimes even 45, 50 teaspoons of sugar a day. This is crazy. This is gonna make us sick long term, and it will have deleterious effects on our metabolism. So reduce sugar as much as you can. And if you are dealing with a chronic disease, the recommended amount is actually 15 grams of sugar a day. You will not miss out on anything when you get rid of seed oils from your diet. You probably know them more under name of vegetable oils, oftentimes touted as the heart healthy vegetable oils. There is absolutely nothing healthy about these oils. The proper name is seed oils because they are mostly made from seeds. And they are made in laboratory settings. They have to undergo a bunch of chemical processes to get them to the stage of this neutrally smelling yellowish liquid that can be used for cooking. It dates back to the beginning of the 20th century, and it was marketed as a better option to traditional lard and tallow. But let me tell you this, this wasn't the right choice for the health of humanity. We should dump seed oils, stop using them altogether. Most people will know that vegetable oils have a lot higher ratio of omega-6 fatty acids to omega-3 fatty acids, and that is problematic for our metabolism. But also the chemical structure is so unnatural that our bodies struggle to get rid of the seed oils from our system for many weeks. And if you eat it every day, it is a recipe for disaster. Now, if you're one of those people that cannot live without French fries, I have a solution for you. If you really love French fries that much, make them yourself, but fry them in lard or tallow. Believe or not, even though it is loaded with calories, it does not have the same deleterious effect on your health as frying French fries in the vegetable oils. Number two, water should be the main source of hydration. Forget about coffees, teas, even herbal teas don't count. And I don't even want to mention any sodas or juices. These drinks have nothing in common with good hydration. Focus on getting water from good sources. Now, I realize most of us don't have access to fresh spring water. Those of us that do are super lucky. So the next best thing you can do is to get a good water filter. The one I use, you see right behind me, it is Berkey filter, and I have it for the last 15 years. and I can tell a difference between the water I filter at home and anything else that I drink outside. And let me tell you this, I can't drink tap water that I usually give you in the restaurant. I can tolerate bottled water, but I can tell a difference. The other weekend, I was away and I was drinking mostly bottled water and I was very thirsty. I was drinking a lot, going to the bathroom a lot, and I just didn't feel hydrated. Only when I came back home and I had my own water with some extra electrolytes that I felt satisfied. So yeah, get a good quality water filter and focus on drinking water mostly. Number three healthy habit is lift weights or do high intensity interval training. It took me a while to learn this because I just didn't like to lift weights. But in fact, it is one of the most healthy ways of exercising. And even if the gym isn't an option for you, you can get a few free weights, some skipping rope, and you can construct a pretty good exercise routine in the comfort of your own home and do it efficiently and cheaply. Second great option is the high intensity interval training, which is completely opposite to many hours of doing aerobics training. And yeah, you basically need 30 minutes. You can go on YouTube and pull up some of the exercises. It doesn't have to be sophisticated, but this rhythm of high intensity rest, high intensity and rest does wonders to our bodies. Mostly it's because both when it comes to the high intensity interval training and weight training, you have this release of human growth hormone, which as we age declines. So forcing the production of it through appropriate exercise is really beneficial to our overall health and longevity. And number four healthy habit is to eliminate snacking. I know this might be a tough one for many of us, but it is so worth doing it. And the mechanism is this: your body was not designed to release insulin throughout the day that frequently, and it doesn't matter what you eat. Anytime you eat, it will trigger release of insulin, which is a hormone very much necessary, but we don't need it that much and that frequently throughout the day. So the best choice would be to stick with 2, maximum 3 meals a day. And it is a lot easier to achieve if you are on a low carb, keto or carnivore diet, because you just feel satiated for so much longer, and then your insulin will not be triggered as frequently, and it has tremendous benefits to your overall health. Now, if you do have to snack, or you are at the beginning of the journey and you just have to do something with your hands, just try not to snack in the evening. That is by far the worst habit with worst health outcomes. If you have to start somewhere, start with cutting out snacking past 7 p.m. And number five healthy habit you should start today is to breathe through your nose. I know not a lot of people pay attention to it, but it is so important to breathe through your nose. And if you do this observation, just walk in the street and pay attention to people, a lot of them have their mouth slightly open, and these are the mouth breathers. Well, unless you're in the community that is masking outdoors, then you will not be able to carry out this experiment, but you'll have to trust me on this one. There are a lot of people that breathe through their mouths, and this is one of these bad habits that hasn't been addressed adequately. It's kind of flying under the radar. It is really important to breathe through your nose. Most people will agree that breathing through your mouth will eventually lead to sleep apnea, but there are so many other chronic conditions and diseases that can be traced back to mouth breathing. You'll be shocked. Our functioning of the brain, our sleep at night, our response to stress, our digestion, a lot of it is related to breathing through your mouth or through your nose. The doctor that made the most of the research about the nose breathing versus mouth breathing is Dr. Buteyko, and the person that popularized the Buteyko method in the West is Patrick McEwen, and I will link both of these gentlemen information in the description box. You should definitely research it in detail, because the details and the shocking information about the mouth breathing versus nose breathing is just staggering, and we just don't talk about it. It's just not a subject. But yeah, we should be breathing through our noses. And one of the things that you can do very easily and cheaply is to actually put the tape over your mouth before you go to sleep, and sleep with your mouth tape at night. And that is one of the best ways to ensure that you are breathing through your nose. Now, during the day, you can focus on nose breathing. And for some people that are used to breathing through their mouth, it is actually quite challenging, because if you don't use your nostrils, they will actually get somewhat obstructed. So in the beginning, it will feel like you don't have enough air when breathing through your nose. But continue doing it, because your nostrils will open up, and then you will be able to breathe through your nose comfortably. And the last one for this week's video is to take cold showers or cold baths. Alternatively, you can go for exposure to heat, like saunas. The purpose of these exercises is to increase the limits of your body to what you can tolerate as discomfort. Now, personally, I love the cold, so I go for the cold showers, but some people prefer to do the saunas. The end result is the same. It is to increase the response of your immune system and mental tolerance for discomfort. There is a saying, be hard on yourself and life will be easy on you, or be easy on yourself and life will be hard on you. You can just start taking cold showers and your life will be a lot easier. If you opt for the cold exposure, the person that really made an art and science out of it is Wim Hof. He actually developed the Wim Hof method, and this is a combination of breathing exercises and cold showers or cold baths. You can Google him or find him on YouTube. He has his own application. If you're just starting out, I think for a period of time it is free, so you can time yourself when it comes to the breathing, and you can set the goals when it comes to the cold showers, how long you should be taking them and for whatever period of time. I will link his information in the description box as well. Give it a try. You will not be disappointed. All right, so this will do it for part one of healthy habits you should start today to ensure optimal health and longevity. We will continue next week. If you have some good tips, put them in the comments below. And if you haven't yet, subscribe, hit that notification bell, and I will see you in Friday Findings. Bye.